The story begins in Odessa, where Fred and Frances Paynter built their new home in 1951. Fred included their children, Ann and Kenneth, in the making of a garden. When Michael came along, he was quickly initiated. Aside from his kids, Fred's pride and joy was the garden, especially the lawn, a tradition he passed down to his sons. In San Antonio, Kenneth and wife Arlene have made their own family memories of afternoons on the lawn with their two daughters. In San Marcos, Michael and Robin Harry tend a small patch of grass in the bungalow they renovated. The brothers differ in style, but their grass is a mutual tribute to their dad, who died in 1989.
Dad loved the yard. I mean, he'd come home from work and the yard. And he was, at one time, he was district credit manager for Firestone. So we lived all over, particularly mainly in Texas, but there was a stint where we moved to Jacksonville, Florida. Well, he fell in love with St. Augustine grass. Transferred to Odessa. Well, from Florida to Odessa, it's not the same. And he wanted St. Augustine grass. And everybody said, Fred, you can't have St. Augustine grass in West Texas because it'll die in the winter.
But with soil and a few runners, Fred planted a lawn that looked great for over 50 years. As the kids grew up, it became a family hangout and shared responsibility.
Every Saturday, I would have to mow the yard. And one time I was out there mowing, and my mother comes out the door. I'm singing as I'm mowing. And she says, she came out and told me to quit singing while I was mowing because I didn't do as good a job mowing when I sang. And then they told me that I needed to start mowing the other way every other week because the grass was leaning.
Their dad's routine, fertilizer a few times a year, and copperas at the start of the growing season has become part of his son's yearly rhythm.
People will stop and say, how come your grass is so green? You water a lot? And I say, I do what the Texas A&M Agricultural Extension Service recommends, a half an inch of water a week, you know. And so I'll do that. But the thing that makes it so green is copperas.
So you grow up doing that, and then it's like, must not have yard. Oh no, I must have yard. This is my dad's influence. Don't trample the yard, right? The yard must look good. So those are there so you can, you know, get from one place to another.
He and Ken mow tall, another lesson from Dad, to protect roots from cold, heat, and drought. They also inherited their dad's love of garden whimsy. Fred's treasured windmill inspired Ken to spin a few ideas of his own.
I had it by the pool and I was going to fix it like it is right now, except I was going to have it looking like it was filling up the pool. And then the Texas sage outgrew the hat of the windmill, so I decided to try to find a little stock tank and make it look like it was actually pumping. And once I did that, I knew I had to have some water plants of some kind in there, and water plants led to goldfish. Once I put that stock tank in, the birds would rather go to the stock tank and drink than the bird bath.
And grab a quick bite. Ken and Erlene's daughters were little when they adopted the family tradition, helping Dad with the yard.
That tree, my youngest daughter Allison found a little oak tree. It was about that big when she found it. And she said she wanted to plant it, so I tried to find a place that would kind of balance out in the yard.
Daughter Stephanie influenced his choice for shrubs to replace sickly ones around the pool.
Well, my oldest daughter, who lives in Georgetown, said, Daddy, why don't you get some Texas hardy plants, get a Texas sage and try that, and it's been great.
Ken's garden also reflects his mom, who passed away in 2004.
The evergreen is a tree that my mother had gotten as a little Christmas tree plant, and she gave it to me, and I planted it. And it could be 10 or 15 years old now. Time flies.
The autumn sedum he brought from Odessa was a favorite of hers for many years. Her bird of paradise is another heirloom.
That's from her backyard, her alley in Odessa.
Michael's story includes their mom's cat. His backyard fountain responds to his life's journey, past and present.
I grew up in West Texas, where there's no water at all. And I just like hearing that sort of like babbling noise in the background. I just wanted like to break up all the noise from all the wah, wah, wah stuff.
His small yard on a noisy route is far different than the acres he once gardened. In his new home, he met drainage and size challenges with his dad's tenacity and vision.
I'd stand up on the roof and look down at the yard from the roof and just kind of like clear my mind and just sort of stare unfocused at the yard underneath, and I'd just kind of like things would just pop into my head.
One was a storage shed he built, designed to look as old as the house, thanks to ancient barn tin from a friend's dad. Serendipity played a hand in its character.
Just living in such a busy area right here that I just started finding hubcaps. So I started putting them up everywhere, and then people started coming by and saying, hey, can I buy this hubcap from you? Because it looks just like the one that I lost on my car. I said, well, no, I won't sell it to you, but you can have it. But the deal is you got to bring me another hubcap.
Although anachronistic, scavenged neon signs fit right in. When he rebuilt the deck as an overlook, he knew just how to connect the two spaces. Then he hand-designed stepping stones with homemade molds.
I was very influenced by just all the yard art that I have seen in Austin, and really that was appealing to me.
But it was in San Marcos where he got his sculptures, student rejects from Texas State University. One he bought, a Beth O'Reilly, for its significance to accompany the grass his dad would have planted as its backdrop.
So I think he would like the part out in the front, you know, where it's nice. Nice yard. I don't know what he would think about all the rest of it.
Fred's lessons also live on through Ken's daughter, Allison, who styled her vision, with a little grass, of course, in Colorado. The wheel spins on.